Parallel buses. Parallel connections carry encoded data from multiple sources to several alternate destinations. Such connection structures are called buses, as you can see in the figure. Figure shows the general idea of bus connection structures. It is not realizable directly as shown. Since the bus signals are shared between the data sources, only one of them should provide data at once. Multiplexed buses. Multiplexer selects among the data sources. The multiplexer selects the value to drive the bus signals based on a control signal generated by a control section. If the bus has small n number of data sources, an n input multiplexer is required for each bit of the encoded data transmitted over the bus. The multiplexer may be implemented as a single n-input multiplexer, or it may be subdivided into sections distributed around the chip. One extreme form of subdivision of bus multiplexers is the fully distributed structure as shown in the figure. The data signals are connected in a chain going past all the sources and then routed to the destinations. Example for this kind of bus is wishbone bus. The GovNet core uses a simple form of wishbone bus for each of the instruction, data and I/O ports connection. The signals with a_O suffix for are outputs from a component, and the signals with _I suffix are inputs. When multiple _O signals are to be connected to a_I signal, a multiplexer is required. Figure shows an example problem which indicates connection of two ADC controllers with a keypad controller to a GovNet core using distributed multiplexers. The GovNet core is the single source for the port address and control signals, and for the output data signals, so no multiplexer is needed for those signals. The controllers each provide input data and acknowledgement signals, so distributed multiplexers are needed for them. We can decode the port address to derive the controller strobe signals and multiplexer select signals. We choose the first ADC controller when the port address is 0 or 1, the second ADC when the port address is 2 or 3, and the keypad controller when the port address is 4. The connections are shown in figure. Tri-state buses. Outputs of a tri-state driver can be turned off by placing it in a high impedance or high Z state. The symbol for a tri-state driver is shown in the figure. When the enable input is 1, the driver behaves like an ordinary output, driving either a low or high logic level on the output. When the enable input is 0, the driver enters the high impedance state by turning its output stage transistor off. Tri-state bus is a bus with multiple data sources by using tri-state drivers on the outputs of each data source. One driver for each bit of encoded data provided by the source, and connect the enable inputs of the drivers for a given source together as shown in the figure. The control section selects a particular source to provide data by setting the enable input of the source's driver to 1 and all other enable inputs to 0. Advantage of tri-state bus is reduction in wiring. There are some important issues to be considered in tri-state bus. The first one is wire delay. As wires connect all of the sources and destinations, they are generally long and heavily loaded with the capacitance of the drivers and inputs. Second issue is a difficulty in designing the control section that selects among data sources. The control section must ensure that one source's drivers are disabled before any other sources drivers are enabled. This is shown in the figure. When the enable input of a driver changes to zero, there is a delay T off before the driver disconnects from the bus. When the enable input changes to one, there is a delay T on before the driver delivers a valid low or high logic level on the bus. In the intervening time, the bus floats. The floating bus can cause spurious switching. Floating logic levels on the bus signals can be avoided by attaching a weak keeper to the signal, as shown in the figure. The keeper consists of two inverters providing positive feedback to the bus signal. Driver contention can occur during change from one data source to another due to overlap of data of the two sources. To avoid driver contention, we can introduce a dead cycle between turn off and turn on of two drivers used to delay enable, as shown in figure. Issue number 3 is not all CAD tools and implementation fabrics support tri-state buses. Modeling tri-state drivers in Verilog. Verilog allows us to use the keyword TRI instead of wire for a net connected to the output of a tri-state driver. Write the following declaration in a module try space t underscore out, or the following port declaration module m within the bracket output space tri space a comma and so on. Any other driver contributing 0 or 1 overrides high impedance Z value. SN 7416541 component manufactured by Texas Instruments is a dual 8-bit bus buffer driver in a package for a use in a PCB system. The internal circuit of the component is shown in figure. We have to develop a Verilog model for the component. The Verilog model is as shown. Module SN74X16541 output underscore try 7:0 y1 comma y2 input 7:0 1 a1 comma a2 input enable 1 underscore 1 comma input enable 1 underscore 2 enable 2 1 enable 2 2. So there are only two statements. The first one is assign y1, so we are using conditional operator. The condition here is and between not of enable 1 and not of enable 1 underscore 2. If this condition is true, A1 is assigned to Y1, or else 8-bit high impedance is assigned to Y1. Second condition is assign Y2 equals not of enable 2 underscore 1 ended with not of enable 2 underscore 2. This is the condition. If this condition is true, A2 is assigned to Y2, or else 8-bit high impedance is assigned to Y2. Open drain buses. Each driver connects the drain terminal of a transistor to the bus signal. When any of the transistors is turned on, it pulls the bus signal to a low logic level. When all of the transistors are turned off, the termination register pulls the bus signal up to a high logic level. If multiple drivers try to drive a low logic level, their transistors simply share the current load. If there is a conflict with one or more drivers trying to drive a logic low level and others letting the bus to be pulled up, the low level drivers win. This kind of bus is called a wired AND bus. Since the bus signal is only one if all of the driver's output is one. If any driver outputs zero, the bus signal goes to zero. The AND function arises from the wiring together of the transistor drains. Drivers can use bipolar transistors instead of MOSFET transistors. The collector terminal of transistor is connected to the bus signal as shown in the figure. Such a driver is called a open collector driver. Utilization or usage of three buses is as follows. Open drain or open collector buses are usually found outside ICs. That is, they can be used to connect to different ICs. Multiplexed or tri-state buses are used within ICs. So inside ICs, we can make use of multiplexed or tri-state kind of buses. Open drain drivers in Verilog. Assign one to the net to represent a driver whose output transistor is turned off. Model pull up on open drain using WAND net. For example, WAND bus underscore signal. Resolved value is a logical AND of driver values. Next is bus protocols. The specification of a bus protocol includes a list of the signals that interconnect compliant components and a description of the sequences and timing of values on the signals to implement various bus operations. This allows independent design of components and also ensures interoperability. Standard bus protocols include PCI, VXI, etc. They are used for connecting boards in a system. Protocols like AMBA for ARM, Core Connect for IBM, Wishbone for Open Cores for connecting blocks within a chip. Example, GUMNET Wishbone. The signals are port underscore CYC underscore O, a cycle control signal that indicates that a sequence of IO port operations is in progress. Port underscore STB underscore O, a strobe control signal that indicates an IO port operation is in progress. Port underscore WV underscore O, a write enable control signal that indicates the operation is an IO port write. Port underscore ACK underscore I, a status signal that indicates that the IO port acknowledges completion of the operation. Port underscore ADR underscore O, the 8-bit IO port address. Port underscore DAT underscore O, the 8-bit data written to the addressed IO port by an out instruction. Port underscore DAT underscore I, the 8-bit data read from the addressed IO port by an INP instruction. Timing of GUMNET IO write operations without wait cycles is shown in the first part of the figure, and with one wait cycle is shown in the second part of the timing diagram. When the GUMNET core executes an out instruction, it performs a port write operation. The timing of operations is shown in the figure. Transitions are synchronized by the system clock. The GUMNET starts a write operation by driving the port underscore ADR underscore O signal with the address computed by the out instruction and the port underscore DAT underscore O signals with the data from the source register of the out instruction. It sets the port underscore CYC underscore O, port underscore STB underscore O and port underscore WV underscore O control signals to 1 to indicate commencement of the write operation. The system in which the GUMNET is embedded decodes the port address to select an IO controller and to enable the addressed output register to store the data. If the addressed controller is able to update the register within the first clock cycle, it sets the port underscore ACK underscore I signal to 1 in that cycle as shown in the figure. On the next rising clock edge, the GUMNET sees output GUMNET sees port underscore ACK underscore I at 1 and completes the operation by driving port underscore CYC underscore O, port underscore STB underscore O, and port underscore WE underscore O back to zero. If, on the other hand, the addressed controller is slow and is not able to update the output register within the cycle, it leaves port underscore ACK underscore I to zero, as shown in second part of the figure. The GUMNET sees port underscore ACK underscore I at zero on the rising clock heads and extends the operation for a further cycle. The controller can keep port underscore ACK underscore I at zero for as long as it needs to update the register. Eventually, when it is ready, it drives port underscore ACK underscore I to 1 to complete the operation. This form of synchronization involving strobe and acknowledgement signals is often called handshaking. The timing of GUMNET I/O read operations without wait cycles and with one wait cycle is shown in the diagram. The GUMNET performs a port read operation when it executes. The GUMNET performs a port read operation when it executes an ENP instruction. The timing for the operation shown in the figure is similar to that of port write. The GUMNET starts the port read operation by driving the port address port underscore ADR underscore O signals with the computed address, driving the port underscore CYC underscore O and port underscore STB underscore O signals to 1 and leaving port underscore WE underscore O at 0. Again, the system decodes the address to select an I/O controller and enable the addressed input register onto the port underscore DAT underscore I signals. The controller drives the port underscore ACK underscore I signal to 1 as soon as it has supplied the data, either during the first cycle as shown in figure first part of the figure or in subsequent cycle as shown in the second part of the figure. On seeing port underscore ACK underscore I at 1, the GUMNET refreshes the data from the port underscore DAT underscore I signals to the destination register identified in the INP instruction. It then completes the port read operation by driving port underscore CYC underscore O and port underscore STB underscore O back to 0.